the Asian Women Cooperative Development Forum. In 1990, three national co-op organizations and a non-government organization or an NGO that promotes co-ops formed AWCF. Another member came in 1994. AWCF's first function was being an informal, collaborative forum of its founding organizations to know and address gender issues and women-specific concerns in the co-op setting. Gender awareness was initially pursued among the founders as female and male leaders, staff, and members. Putting women up front, strategies and techniques for organizing women in cooperatives in Asia. This was AWCF's first regional meeting of women and men co-op leaders. The groundbreaking event was held in 1990 in Cebu City, Philippines. In 1993, being an informal forum, AWCF became a resource center and advocacy body on gender and co-ops in Asia. AWCF addresses gender issues in and through co-ops. It believes that co-ops, being people-based and democratically run and managed socioeconomic institutions, have the values, infrastructure, resources to bring about gender equality and equity, improve gender relations, improve condition of the economically and socially disadvantaged, many of whom are women. As resource center, it assists and provides services to co-op organizations and social development agencies or SDAs in gender mainstreaming and co-op development. As advocacy body, it promotes gender awareness and integration of gender concerns in co-ops and SDAs in the international, regional, and local levels. To work on gender issues in society and in co-ops, AWCF's objectives are, first, to strengthen the capacities of members and non-members in promoting, integrating, and practicing gender equality and gender equity and the empowerment of women in their co-op structure. Second, to build the capacities and skills of women for increased participation in the leadership and decision-making in co-ops and other community-based savings and credit organizations. Third, to advocate for co-ops to be aware of the particular needs of women entrepreneurs and for co-ops to use their resources to benefit women entrepreneurs. Fourth, to advocate for co-ops to use their resources to provide services needed specifically by women arising from their multiple roles. AWCF believes that transformative co-op organizations are more democratic and more caring of their members and communities. It believes that in these co-ops, women and men can best work together to achieve a just, humane, development-oriented, issue-focused, and gender-sensitive society to achieve quality life. AWCF hopes to enable co-op organizations to pursue the gender agenda, to facilitate the development and installation of mechanisms for women's active and effective participation as co-op members and leaders, to enable women and men to work together as partners in the co-op movement. Overall, AWCF works to implement human resource programs and development services that strengthen its capacity to transform co-ops and to strengthen gender programs. Enable research and documentation of programs and activities on gender and development or GAD, and facilitate discussion of cross-cutting issues and their resolutions that affect women and men in co-ops.
What is the vision of AWCF? What is the mission of AWCF? These are the goals of AWCF.
What are AWCF's core programs? These are gender mainstreaming, women in leadership and decision making, women entrepreneurship development, regional policy advocacy, and advocacy and support services for women. Gender mainstreaming is enabling co-ops, community-based savings and credit organizations, and development NGOs and people's organizations or POs to mainstream and integrate gender concerns and perspectives in their policies, programs, and activities. Mainstreaming is not about adding a woman component or even a gender component into an existing activity. It goes beyond increasing women's participation. It is bringing the experience, knowledge, and interests of women and men to sustain development. Women in leadership and decision-making is promoting women's increased participation in leadership and decision-making in co-ops, community-based savings and credit organizations, and development NGOs and POs engaged in co-op promotion. Women entrepreneurship development is enhancing women's entrepreneurial skills and advocating the mobilization of the co-ops' resources to support women-owned and or women-managed enterprises. Advocating the setting up of co-op business development centers or BDCs. Business development centers to provide services to members who have micro, small, and medium enterprises or MSMEs. Build capacities of women entrepreneurs, especially those in micro-enterprises, and provide microfinance, education and skills upgrading, physical space or facilities, access to appropriate low-cost technology, and information and communication technology, and other services. Regional policy advocacy is analyzing the gender impact of cross-cutting issues that affect co-ops and community-based savings and credit organizations in Asia, and lobbying for policy change supportive of co-ops and women at the local and international levels. Advocating co-op issues and concerns with different bodies such as the United Nations, the International Cooperative Alliance, NGOs, civil society groups, and their different summits and conferences. Advocacy and support services for women is advocating for co-ops to use their resources for support services to women members in response to practical and strategic needs. AWCF knows that there are more challenges up ahead, as put forward by each member organization and by various developments in the region. Thus, it is moving to further strengthen its governance through policies, services, and restructuring, to involve more its leadership in strategic directions, and to work on its new 6-year strategic goals. In July 2007 in Thailand, in AWCF's 4th General Assembly and Network Strategizing, it crafted its strategic goals for years 2008 to 2013 as first, as a resource center for co-ops and GAD focus on TL development, enterprise development and fair trade, and development of support services for health, family, environment, and well-being. Second, Asia-wide country focus to include the Mekong Basin and other countries with membership requirements restricted to co-ops or organizations supporting co-ops working at the national level. Third, involvement in legislative advocacy and funding negotiation. The strategies formulated toward AWCF strategic goals are: first, gender equity or equality programs and advocacy in TL. Second, programs on enterprise development and fair trade, ICT, and legislative or policy counseling. Third, membership expansion, country-specific, cooperative organization-specific. Fourth, financial sustainability, internal sourcing, juice or contribution, external sourcing, donor or grants, or income generation. As a regional body, AWCF will continue facilitating knowledge exchange at the regional level and to keep on searching for innovative and appropriate ways to mainstream gender and empower co-op women based on program priorities that it has identified. All of AWCF's efforts and resources must be focused on its new strategies to sustain its programs and activities and to address the members' felt needs. These are the member organizations of AWCF: Center for Agricultural Extension Volunteers, or CAEV; Credit Union League of Thailand, or CULT; Credit Union Promotion Club, or CUPS; Forum for Indonesian Cooperatives Movement, or Farmasi Indonesia; National Confederation of Cooperatives, or NATCO;
the Socioeconomic Development Organization of Cambodia, or SEDOC;
through NIAP, CAEV serves agriculture co-ops and farm households, has organized co-ops as models of genuine co-ops in Vietnam, which has helped make CAEV a resource group in co-op development for government and international development agencies. CULT has services and programs that include education and training, bookkeeping and accounting, CU promotion, women and youth development, business enterprise development, among others. CULT's Women Cooperative Products Development Center, or WCPC, helps sustain women co-ops' initiatives to create and develop products. CUPS is a partnership of two major grassroots-based CUs in Malaysia. Its members are workers of multinational and mining companies, and plantation workers, paddy farmers, and fisher folks. Its role as coordinating body is to introduce various education and training programs, design and introduce new service and products, and do public relations and establish international links. Its Women's Action Committee in the primary, chapter, and national levels addresses concerns of women members moving on to form the GAD Committee with women and selected gender-sensitized men who joined it after undergoing GST. Farmasi Indonesia, formed as a national network organization in 1987 by 10 NGOs that were concerned with the cooperative movement and in small and medium enterprise, or SME, development in Indonesia. Started as a dialogue forum, it transformed in 1992 into an association, considering its membership-based organization. It offers consultancy, education, and training, information dissemination and promotion concerning community-based co-op development, gender development, and the provision of seed capital. As an extraordinary member of DECOPIN, Indonesia's Council of Co-ops, it can make recommendations to the government as a representative of informal co-ops. NATCO, the Philippines' largest federation of privately initiated and member-based co-ops in terms of geographical reach, membership, financial capacity, and array of services. NATCO's financial services and allied services. Its financial services are the Central Fund, eCoop Banker, MyCoop, Western Union Facilities. Its allied services are the iTech Line for information technology, travel and tours, legal services, training, youth, hostel, gender. It also has its NATCO Enterprise Development Center, which include the Co-op Mart, housing, health, funeral care. There is also the Institute for Co-op Excellence. Has its Women's Congress that acts as a body to initiate gender-related activities, policy changes, and consolidate gains on gender equality within the movement.
SADOC, a non-government organization established in 1991, its field of expertise is in community development, particularly concerning rural and agricultural advancement. After doing humanitarian projects for several years, SADOC focused on implementing income-generating projects and establishing credit unions to help the marginalized poor become self-reliant, thereby assisting in curbing poverty in Cambodia. Its major programs include sustainable agriculture, promotion of agricultural and credit unions, establishment of rice banks, forestry and environment, and promotion of gender equality. It reaches out to at least 5 provinces of Cambodia, covering about 70 villages.
What are AWCF's networks and linkages? AWCF is an NGO in special consultative status with the UN ECOSOC. It maintains partnerships with various development, co-op, and support agencies across the globe.